It's the most wonderful time of the year, the playoffs. For hockey? Well, no, not yet. But it is for floorball at the Warehouse Games from John Boy Media. I'm Steve Dangle, and this is my reaction to my own game, McFlurry Power, my team, taking on John Boy himself and his team, Baggage. So, little behind the scenes. This is day 3. That we've been there at the Warehouse. My team, McFlurry Power, we won our first 2 games. We beat We Got Ice in a nail biter, 3-2 in our first game, and then we crushed Hook Line Sinkers, 11-2. That gave us the number 1 seed and meant we got a bye through to the semifinal. Baggage wasn't as lucky. In fact, they were incredibly unlucky. They outplayed Hook Line Sinker in their first game, lost in the shootout. Their second game was a battle of the brothers, Jimmy O'Brien, John Boy, taking on his brother, Lucas, and Woogas. McFlurry Power got a bye through to the semis. Baggage wasn't so lucky. They had to play in the quarterfinals against Hook Line Sinker, who they lost to in their first game. But Baggage, who was unlucky in their first couple games, they get a pretty convincing win against Hook Line to make it onto the semis to play us. I'm not gonna lie, this was a holy bleep moment for me. Cause like, dude, I'm legitimately like a John Boy fan. I really, really like everything he does. And here I am in like a really competitive floorball tournament playing against him in a building that he owns. Like, what is my life? What is this? And to add extra intrigue to this game, Sam Taskey from Baggage and Nick Bowens from McFlurry Power, they're dating. So we're not all saying it, but we're all sort of thinking it, like, how's this gonna work? Well, McFlurry Power wins the opening shootout. That means we get a 30-second power play. We don't score on it, but shortly after, the two lovebirds go into the corner, and then this happens.
Bowens races to the corner. Oh, here we go. Here we go. Here we go. Feel like we're out on a date with them. Dangle.
Steve Dangle! Are you kidding me?
Whoa! The man who scored just one time during the regular season has put the 1 seed on the board. Let's stir that shit up, McFlurry. What a goal by Steve Dangle. Probably the 1 guy on this floor that you wouldn't have had to account for.
The most unassuming guy. You're so worried about Kelsey. You're so worried about Nick Bowens. You forget Steve Dangle's on the floor, and he just rips it home.
Do you mind if I reenact that celebration for you a little bit?
Yeah! Yeah!
I've never gotten to say this in one of my LFR videos, my post-game videos for the Leafs game, so let me say it now. I shoot, I score, 1-0 me! Not me, my team, McFlurry Power. Dude, I was fired up for this goal from a team perspective and a personal one. From a team perspective, it's the playoffs. It was our first playoff goal. Actually, that I just realized that right now in this moment. I scored our first playoff goal. Our team that had 14 goals in 2 regular season games and I only had 1 of them, somehow I got the first playoff goal. It was just a defensive plug, basically. I was blocking shots, not taking them. But the second thing, and this is the best part, they knew that. Team Baggage knew that, and we knew that they knew that. Again, this is day 3. We've all watched each other's games. Everyone in the tournament has sat there in the stands for everyone else's games when they weren't playing. So me and McFlurry Power, Nick Bowens, Chelsea Dinnan, Kyle McDonald, we're all looking at the other teams, and we're talking about their tendencies and stuff like that. And then the day of the game arrives, and we're like, okay, what does Baggage do? What is their identity? We know Jimmy's fast. We know Sam is a great net front presence. Krauser can kind of move around and do everything. But then we thought, okay, well, what do they expect us to do? And right away, we're like, well, they're not going to expect me to be up. And you can see on this play, like, look at this. Look at where Kraus is, way up. He's there protecting Chelsea, who's way up in the zone. Jimmy's directing traffic, pointing, hey, make sure you got Chelsea. And even Jake Storiali, the goalie, like, he's actually kind of cheating towards Chelsea. Like, people are expecting a pass here. Nope, rip it! And you can tell by my, like, delayed reaction. Dude, I didn't even know it was in. I couldn't see it. But we got on the board first, and I was jacked about it. 1-0 us! And shortly after, all gas, no brakes, baby. We go straight to the Pavel play. We want to keep the pressure on, so we go to the Pavel play. We get a 4-on-3 power play for 30 seconds with Pavel Barber as our 4th.
Barber looking, gets it over to Dangle. One time, a follow-up by Bowens is no good. Story Ollie with back-to-back stops.
Again, baggage leaving me wide open. I mean, that's what I would have done, to be fair. I would have covered Pavel Barber. I rip a one-timer. I don't get it, but we get the ball back. And Pavel. Oh, Pavel.
On the Pavel play. Oh, the sweeper behind the net. No good. Bowens can't follow it up. Tasky trying to clear. There's a goal by Barber again.
Let's go, baby. Stir it up. Stir it up.
That's right. My bitches, stir that shit up.
No, Tasky.
Pavel Barber has given the one seed a 2-0 lead.
God, he's so gross! Pavel Barber puts McFlurry Power up 3-0. This dude is 3-for-3 with us. Everyone gets one Pavel play a game. We are the only team where he has scored in every game for us so far. And they are mad. Story Ollie's mad. They didn't think there was time left on the clock for the Pavel play. There was. There was 3 seconds. We're up 2-0. Action doesn't stop there. All gas, no brakes. Pavel play for Team Baggage now. I had a few blocks on this Pavel play, and I did something that I had been looking to do all tournament but wasn't really able to do. I got in front of a Pavel Barber shot and blocked it. Now, it wasn't with my leg. Actually, that might have been less painful. He grips it and rips it. Look at this. Look at this. Bang off my thumb. And look at my slow-mo reaction. Ah! Part of my willingness to block shots in this tournament is this is the ball. Like, this isn't a puck. It's not even like the orange plastic ball that'll leave a tattoo on you. It's this. It's nice and light. And if it hits you like in the meat of your thigh, it's not gonna be a big issue for you. It'll sting, but like you're not gonna buckle and fall down like a guy getting hit in the skate laces. But if it hits you in the bone, like on your thumb on a digit, yeah, that hurt. But we end up killing the Pavel play off. They got some great looks though. We would get another regular power play, 3-on-2 before the period ended due to a handball. We didn't end up scoring on that one. We had our chances. We go to intermission though, up 2-0. We're feeling pretty good. And they even got to interview yours truly.
Feeling pretty hot coming off of your first goal in the tournament yesterday. Are you gonna score more this game?
Listen, I'm just as surprised as everyone else. That'd be cool, but right now I got to worry about protecting the GWG.
Love that. What GWG?
Game-winning goal.
Game-winning. Okay, I like that. I like the acronym.
So that was the intermission. We get a quick breather, and then we go right back to work. All gas, no brakes! Nick Bowens, this is just ridiculous.
Go get him. There. Remember, she exploded for a hat trick in the semifinals last season. Oh, look at this, Bowens. Wraps, stop, and goal! Nick Bowens extending McFlurry Power's lead to 3-0.
I mean, that is just a dogged effort on the ball. Story Ollie makes the save, but he can't make the second one. Bowen's all over this thing, and he scores. Like, this is basically perfect case scenario for us. Because Baggage was so locked in on Chelsea Dinnan. She scored, like, I think 5 goals against hook, line, sinker in their last game. Why wouldn't they be worried about her? But, like, 5.5 minutes into the game, goal from me, goal from Pavel, goal from Nick. So, yes, they shut down Chelsea, but everyone else got a goal, which we like. We also like, they mentioned my booty.
Tasky. Blocked by Dangle's Booty.
It's Block City.
Yeah, I think that's the name of his latest podcast.
Is that right?
Booty. Oh, he picks it off.
That was fun. You know what was even more fun? Nick Bowen scoring a Michigan goal that ended up getting disallowed.
Oh, he's going Michigan. That's above the knees. Above the knees. He went for that Michigan, bobbled it on the stick and tried to toss
awesome,
it over.
Though.
That would have been awesome. But in floorball, unfortunately, got to keep it below the knees, and it's difficult to pull off that play in this sport.
Yeah, no, it looked cool, but you can't do that. But after that, it's just smooth sailing. Baggage keeps getting their chances. They're trying to get around us, and they just can't find the right angle. Honestly, I'll talk from a personal perspective. I thought this was my best game. I felt great about this game. Blocked a lot of shots, cut off a lot of passes. But remember I was saying all gas, no brakes? That's not what the third period was for us at all. No gas, all brakes. We made a huge mistake against Baggage and we tried to park the bus. dude, they're too good a team to do that to. And if you keep giving them chances, they're going to bury them. Jimmy O'Brien, great player. Sam Tasky, dogged in front of the net. Krauser, always a threat. And they begin the third period with a power play, because if a team is leading by 3 goals or more heading into the third period, the team who is down starts with a power play. We put Chelsea in the box. Again, just get her a little extra rest. That's our top gun right there. And just a one-timer over to Krauser for the Ovi.
Knocks it away from his girlfriend.
Yes, that's
Krauser!
It.
That's the one!
You gotta get him moving laterally.
Baggage on the board thanks to Jeff Krauser. His second goal of the tourney has gotten Baggage back within two, still 4.5 to play.
Just a great play. Jimmy has been such a shooter today, and all the attention drawn to him, and just leaves it wide open for Krauser there.
Dude, I hate how I'm defending this. I hate what I'm doing with my feet. This was my worst play of the game. And if you look at the overhead, like, I'm so close to getting it, but I don't get it, do I? So, that's not great, because, yeah, we were up by 3, now we're only up by 2, and it's a 2-goal lead with 4.5 minutes to go. That's a lot of time. So that was a play of mine that I didn't really like. Let me show you a play, though, that completely encapsulates the type of player I was trying to be. I knew I wasn't going to be able to do the crazy cool tricks that Chelsea is able to do and rip it the way she does. I knew I wasn't going to be able to have all the offensive weapons that Nick Bowens has. I was going to have to be a defense first, stay at home grinder. There was a ball race between me and Krauser, and we both ended up getting to it at the same time, but the ball goes off him and out of bounds. And then you see me give a little fist pump, because that means it's our ball. If I can put on a nice shot, great. I didn't get many opportunities to do that. If I can make a nice pass, great. I didn't get a lot of opportunities to do that. This was the sort of thing that I had to do in my role in order for me to be effective for our team. That's the role of a role player. If you try to carry the team, you're gonna fail, because you're not the guy who carries the team. I can't carry a team. I can play my role, though. And to me, like, this is a clip where, does anything really happen? Not really, but if you think about it, I stopped them from getting a scoring chance and I gave us possession. That, to me, made me feel great in my role. And so does this. Pavel gassing me up.
O'Brien walks right in, tries to find an angle, instead it's Dangle.
Dangle with another block. He's blocking everything today.
It felt like I was blocking everything, but I couldn't block this. Jimmy O'Brien, John Boy himself, with less than a minute to go. What a snipe.
All right,
two guys high.
Yeah, they're going to apply pressure on Dangle, who throws it all the way down.
Here we go. Jim, we're going to go for a run here. Look for the pass to Krauser. Oh, he just shoots it! And he scores!
From 50 feet out, Jimmy O'Brien's got Baggett back within one with 42 seconds remaining.
Unbelievable. Jimmy, a late game guy, always seems to come alive in the closing ends of the third.
Okay, yep, nope, we don't like that. You can tell from my face that we don't like that. We don't like that! Dude, Jimmy was so good. It's almost like it's his tournament or something. The way this tournament started, so I'm sitting on the sideline and Baggage is playing in the first game and Jimmy is the first player in the first game with the ball. I'm sitting there, you know, worried about how I'm gonna do. I'm like, I wonder what the pace is gonna be like. This is Jimmy. I'm sitting there like, oh my God, I'm gonna die. So he was able to run like that. And he was telling me behind the scenes that, like, he's lost weight, he's gotten into better shape. And then he can shoot like that. So yes, we were still up 1. Yes, there were only 42 seconds on the clock. Actually, 42 felt like a lot. And this is why it felt like a lot. Shot from Sam Tasky, look at how close.
The centering pass goes all the way deep in the narrow end. Tasky with under 30.
Tasky,
oh,
off
shot.
The bar?
Did that hit the back of the net or the
bar?
Oh, there's a clock stoppage.
We have to take a look.
There is a lot going on here. K-Mac with his hands in the air.
Dude, so close. So close. And there's a reason that Chris Rose and Pavel Barber in the broadcast booth thought this went in or thought it went off the crossbar. It looks like it in real time, I gotta be honest. But as you can see, it goes off of Jimmy's stick just by fluke. Ooh, that was close. We managed to get the rest of it, and with a win, a 3-2 win over Baggage, McFlurry Power has a berth in the final of Warehouse Games Floorball 2. Are you kidding me? Are you kidding me? We win our next game and we get a banner. But first, we gotta play the winner in the final of We Got Ice versus Woogas. Two of the best teams at the tournament. Dude, I can't wait to watch this game. So, that is it for this one. Thank you very much for watching. Click like if you like this video. Click subscribe if you really liked it. Tell all your friends. I'll see you in the final of Floorball 2 against, we'll just have to see.